Latin porifera, that is the biology of Leucosolenia. Biology of Leucosolenia, that is a representative sponge. So Leucosolenia, as we have said earlier, belongs to the class Calcispongi. They belong to the calcareous sponge. Calcareous sponge. And they are also tubular in nature. They occur in colonies. They occur in colonies. So this group, we are going to talk about these are the characteristics, you know, the general characteristics of Leucosolenia. They belong to the class Calcispongi. So they are calcareous sponge, they are tubular, and they are colony. So their habits are the habitat. Then we are also going to talk about the structure, then the feeding. Then we are also going to talk about the gaseous exchange, and excretion, and lastly the reproduction. So we want to talk about the habit. The Leucosolenia have two forms. We have the adult, and the young, you know, the young ones. So the adults are usually sessile. The adults are sessile. They are attached to rock, you know, that is their habit, while the young ones are free living. They are cilia, they are free swimming, they can move from one place to another because they have, you know, organ for locomotion. But the adult doesn't move. They are attached to rocks in shallow water. That is where you find the adult. So when you talk about their habitat, they are found in marine environment. We have said it earlier, that is where they can be found, marine water. You know, they are found attached to rocks or other substrates, other substratum on, you know, marine environment. So let me draw the structure. When you talk about the structure is something like this. And we have the bigger one. So we have the substratum. You hold fast. Then we have this place. Okay. Just like the two. We have the osculum. So we have the spicules all around the body. We have the spicules all around the body. These are the bud, the young ones. So these spicules go around the body. These are the young ones. So this is the structure. We have the osculum. We also have spicules. We have atrium. We have ostia, we have spicules, all these ones are spicules, all these ones are spicules. We have the bud stage, that is the young ones. These are hold fast for attachment to the substratum. So they are attached to their substratum. So this is the mature one. So this is the structure of Leucosolenia. So we said they look like tubes. So they are tubular, as you can see. So this structure structure consists of three main parts. The body is divided into the outer pinnacodium, the body is also divided into medial medullary, and lastly the inner quadrant. So that is the structure of the body. The body is divided into the outer pinnacodium. So this pinnacodium consists of the pinnacocytes. So these are cells that form pores. So this pinnacodium have pores, holes that connect to the outside to the inside. That's why we call it the pinnacocyte. Then when we talk about the mesoi, consists of the skeletal materials. The skeletal materials are the spicules, and these skeletal materials are called sclerocytes. The sclerocytes, and they also contain the amebocytes. They are also present in the mesophyll. Then the inner part consists of the guanocytes. Inside the sponges, guanocytes. That is the inner part. Inside the sponges. So when we talk about these guanocytes, they are present in the inner part. So these are the three parts: the pinnacodium, the mesoderm, and also the guanodium. Those are the three main parts of sponge or leucosolenia. So when we also move forward to the feeding them, they usually flagella. The water movement of flagella brings about water current. So the spicules, they brings about water current. So water current enter into the pores. There are pores called ostia. These pores, the material they feed on enters into the body through this pore, and they are hooked in the mesoderm by the amoeboid, the amebocytes. The amebocytes are the ones that carry out phagocytosis and thereby breaking down these food materials, and the water or undigested food will left. So this food material will now go in, they will be absorbed into the guanocyte, that is the body cell. So this amebocyte will transport the digested product to where it will be absorbed into the body. So the body cell will pick up the useful product after the amebocyte have carried out the digestion. So it will be absorbed into the body cell. So all digested product will leave out the body through the osculum. That's where undigested product will pass out. Then they also carry out gaseous exchange. Gaseous exchange, how they exchange gas with the external environment. That is through simple diffusion to the body wall. Simple diffusion as well as excretion. They take out, undigested waste products, nitrogenous waste products through, simple diffusion as well. Then we also have the reproduction. They carry out both sexual and asexual reproduction. We said it earlier. And their asexual reproduction, that's where they carry out body. So when they are mature, this part now is a young stage. So this part will just cut off of the whole animal, and it's going to develop into another bigger one. That's what we need that body. So a part will cut off from the whole individual, and because they are colony. They are colonies of cell, one cell. So so only one cell will break off, and it will give rise to the colony of another cell. But when we talk about sexual reproduction, we all know that they are monoecious, they are hermaphrodite. So only one organism has both male and female reproductive system. So that is achieved by fusion of gametes. The male gamete and the female gamete will be produced inside the body, and they will carry out fertilization. That is, one male gamete will fuse the female gamete of another cell, and that will result in zygote. The zygote will develop into the embryo, which will lead to the production of a new cell. So that is how they carry out their own reproduction. So that is what we want to understand about the biology of leucosolenia.